The question is, when will we get a break from the rain? Meteorologist Alison Pryor is tracking this storm and joins us now with more. Hey, Alison.
Hi, Hunter. Yeah, that break from rain is going to be happening really soon. Although we're going to have some more showers today, there's just really going to be kind of some light sprinkles, so not nearly as bad as what we had yesterday and especially on Thursday and Thursday night. But because of all that rain we've had for the past 48 hours, I do have some flood warnings to tell you about. So first, for Lookout Creek, this is affecting Dade and Hamilton counties, kind of around that New England area, and Dade County is currently at 14.3 feet for the creek height, but the good news is it is falling at this time. Now, the Sequatchie River that's extending from Bledsoe down to Marion County, it is still rising at this point, and Pink Rock River in Jackson County in Alabama and extending a little bit further to the west, that's cresting right now. So all these are still in their minor flood stage category, but again, Lookout Creek is falling, so it is going to be exiting that minor flood stage by the end of the day today. So that is some good news. We'll continue to track these flood warnings and keep you updated on those conditions. Now, current sideline radar showing those cloudy skies across our region, and really we're just dealing with some light showers at this time. In fact, some people today, you're not even going to see any rain, so you can still do your outdoor activities. Maybe just have the raincoat with you just in case. Right now we're seeing some rain more widespread throughout Grundy County, some pockets here in Marion County, also in Monroe County in our northeastern portions of our viewing area, and through extending from Ray into McMinn County as well. This whole system is continuing to track off to the east though, so all that heavier rain as well off to the east of our region. We're going to see this clearing out in the next couple of hours. Then we're going to have a break around about lunchtime. So I want to show you a look at our forecasted temperatures overlaid with that rain chances. So by 8:45, I think we're just going to see that rain in our far eastern counties, but you'll notice our temperatures will start to be dropping. I think Altamont, you're already going to be in the 30s at that point, 47 degrees in Chattanooga. That's because that cold front is going to be passing over us. So temperatures will be falling through the day today. At noon, I think we're going to have some breaks in cloud cover, 50 degrees in Dalton. And then for the afternoon, as that more cold air moves in, there's going to be a little bit of residual moisture. We could see some drizzles again in some of the higher elevations with some little bit of sprinkles, but then we'll begin to have a transition over. You'll notice though, those ground temperatures above freezing, so we're not at 32 degrees, but then we'll still have that air temperature a little bit cooler. So some flurries for our far western counties, and then also for our far eastern counties up in the higher elevations. Everybody else in the valley though will be drying out and just seeing those temperatures falling and becoming colder overnight. So we'll be right around freezing for the morning hours on Sunday morning, but then look at this for Sunday afternoon. No clouds in the sky showing up here on Vipercast. 52 degrees in Chattanooga at 3 o'clock. So Sunday is going to be a really nice day, drying conditions across the area. One more thing that I want to add for the day today, it's also going to be breezy. We're going to have west northwest winds really throughout the day, about 10 to 15 miles per hour, gusts at 20 to 25. So looking at that Saturday planner, you'll notice here's those dropping temperatures, 52 at 8 a.m. with a few sprinkles, a little bit nicer with a break around lunchtime. And then for this evening, those higher elevations, you can see some of the sprinkles transitioning over to some snow flurries as well. That 53 that I have for the high today, that's really what the temperature I'm expecting around daybreak this morning, but then it'll be falling through the rest of the day. And then Sunday tomorrow, that's going to be the really nice day of the weekend, 53 and lots of sunshine.
Did I hear you just say snow flurries?
I did, but don't freak out. We're talking about very limited, just higher elevations, and really it's over like 3,000 feet that you're really
we're going skiing is what you're saying.
Hunter Hoagland reporting it first here.